Siemanko, ludzkie systemy, natomiast witam was serdecznie w kolejnym odcinku z Gameplay Ministry z trailerami i zaczynamy od Unleaving Official Release Date Announcement. Patrzymy, czym tutaj nas zaskoczą w tej grze. Jakieś malowanie farbkami. Patrzymy. A, to tak stylizowana gierka jest. Interesting. Trochę przypomina jak jakiś kurde czerwony kapturek albo coś w tym stylu, jakiś wilk niby. To na pewno ma jakąś grubszą historię. Przedstawioną w tej stylistyce. Bio? Okay. Czym jest Wają? Powiedzcie mi, czy go znajdziemy? Nie znajdziemy. To jest wizja Arka chyba, to? Co widzę? Nie, nie jest wizja Arka. Voin. Przepraszam. Voin. I Vion. Właśnie jest roguelike action RPG. O! DNF Duo. Sine Tini. Hitokoshi. Maje Chongiga deotta. No i siema tylko. Ale wiesz, za samo halo to wiesz, nie?
Shinichiro, 당신의 뜻을 행함에 흔들리지 않게 하소서.
Co się dzieje? A trailery oglądamy. Apex Legend.
Today's a good day to cheat death.
The All Father has blessed our target with new means of survival.
The All Father.
Simply remarkable.
The path yep. To victory Apexik. Has changed.
Serduszku.
If the gods are to build, our hunt must be won.
Czy idę na Dune? No miałem iść w tym tygodniu na Dune. Chciałem kumpla jeszcze łyknąć, ale wymiękł. Więc raczej teraz w tym następnym tygodniu, znaczy teraz w tym tygodniu co teraz będzie, się przejdę. Także tak. Taki jest plan. We wtorek idziesz? No właśnie, kurde, też planuję we wtorek, ewentualnie w czwartek, nie? Zobaczę jeszcze. Może bardziej w czwartek, kurde, nie? W czwartek nie streamuję, więc... Tak trochę więcej czasu będzie, nie? Fasta, fasta, fasta! Lubię te trailery, kurde, od Apexa. Są naprawdę zacne. Jak zawsze. Dune Awakening. Arrakis is a test. Few survive it. A wiem. Zresztą od bardzo długiego czasu w czwarty nie streamuję. Już musi być jak stream odpala. Jakiś evencik, premiera gry. 21 chyba się odpala. Bo jest... po 22 jest się odpala GDG z Path of Exile, jedyneczką i dwójeczką. Kurde, ten Dune Awakening taki trochę pokroju Star Warsów, nie? Co tutaj teraz pokazują. Które studio pracuje nad tym Dune Awakening? Co do grafika? Nie, no tak właśnie też mówię, kurde, tak bardziej pokroju tego Jedi'a nowego, nie? Od EA. Kiedyś lepsze gry robili. Nie, słabe te grafiki, nie? Nie wiem, może ten trailer jest taki słaby, nie? Gdzieś tu jeszcze jakieś supermoce, kurde, nie? Supermani. But the humans that do awaken. You awaken. Funcom, a level infinite. Zobaczymy. Legendary. Znowu Dune mamy. Siedem minutowy. Co to jest? Creating worlds behind. O, przepraszam, trochę za cicho było. There's something very spiritual about that sand, which on the surface is really nothing, but underneath has a really diverse biological backstory. One of my favorite lines from Frank Herbert is, when you end a novel, it's like a train coming into the station that doesn't stop. Ale widzę, że kurde na Unreal Engine robią. To kurde, ja nie wiem. Może ten trailer, kurde, był taki kiczowaty, bo teraz jak pokazywali, to całkiem spoko to wyglądało. Arrakis is a test, is what the Fremen say. Zaraz wracam, dwie godziny później. Dune Awakening is a survival game at the base level. And it begins like a traditional survival game, you know, like you're looking for water, you're looking for shelter. You know, where will you find water in the desert? Will you take it from others? So when we talk about survival, sure, we start with the basic kind of survival, survive. And then when you've survived long enough, it's now time to think about political survival and how you progress within the universe. The approach we take when building a world like Arrakis is we kind of have to think about where are the stark lines and how do we draw these epic spaces? How do we make them feel huge and the player feels dwarfed by everything they see around them?
The intention was every time we saw the desert, it was highly brutal. And if you went out into the desert without the right protection and without the right knowledge, that it was sure death. If we looked at references from some of the hottest deserts in the world, the visuals that we saw from those deserts weren't enough. We needed this world to be even harsher.
So we've been working with Legendary since the very beginning. They've been very generous with sharing with us assets from the film and allowing us to see things from the film and allowing us to really understand the vision that Denis Villeneuve has for the world and his characters and the way he's grounding Arrakis. But of course, a game is a much larger scale, so we need to expand upon that vision. We have our own army of concept artists who are sending things back and forth with Legendary all the time. One of my best moments on this project so far, actually, was I got to go and visit the set of the first film with a group of the people from Funcom, the art directors, the lead artists, and we got to walk around in the actual sets that they had built in classic old school set building, massive palaces. And we got to look at the ornithopters from the inside and the outside, right? We got to walk around them and get a sense of their scale.
Well, I think what they had done really well is they'd been quite inspired by the world that we had built in Dune Part One. Now, on a film, you're sort of led on a journey by the director and by the script, whereas in a game, you have the opportunity to sort of create your own narrative and create your own journey.
Nie, no tutaj to ładnie wygląda, powiem wam teraz, jak pokazują, bo tam trailer by taki jest trochę skaszeniony.
And you can build your own stories and your own places, and that to me is the ultimate goal, is to have, you know, complete control.
Using Unreal 5 to create a game is obviously one of the better choices. Unreal 5 gives us flexibility through the blueprinting system. It allows us to handle amazing graphics through the rendering system, the lighting system, such as Lumen. Lumen technology allows proper light bouncing. If I had to say one thing in the game that really benefits from Lumen, it's player-crafted spaces. In our case, it's like you build a room and you place a window, and the window lets in natural light, and the light will fill the room in a way that feels real. And that technology hasn't existed before. Before Unreal 5, in the olden days, you had to use what we called the LOD system. And that meant that you had to create assets at different LOD levels, so it doesn't slow down everybody's computer. With Unreal 5, we have this new technology called Nanite that breaks things down into the right amount of polygons at the right distance. So for us, as a company, this has made an amazing difference to the visual detail of the world. It allows us to create one really amazing looking cliff piece, for example, and then doesn't matter how far away or how close we place it, it performs well and it looks great.
Where Unreal worked for us on Dune was that it was a fantastic pre-production and planning tool.
On Dune 2,
we had some very complicated scenes and we were able to previs all the way from Budapest what the light was going to be doing well in advance. It's the only tool that I've used, I would say, in my
years
of shooting, that is able to be used across a wide spectrum of films by different types of filmmakers.
The most iconic creature in the Dune universe is the sandworm of Arrakis. And so we've tried to represent this in the game in multiple ways. So as a player, your first steps on the open sand, you hear the hiss of the sand in the distance as a sandworm begins to move towards you. And when it gets close, you hear the roar as it erupts from the sand nearby. And at that point, you have only seconds to live if you cannot make it to rocky ground. So this is your first experience with sandworms. And these are the little ones. When you go into the deep desert, when you're harvesting spice, the giant ringmouth sandworms that we've seen in the film will erupt underneath the spice blows and suck harvesters and equipment beneath them. There's really only one rule. The sandworm will always come. Humans have always had this innate drive to create something, to build worlds, whether it's in their head, whether it's in text, whether it's on screens, whether it's in games. Funcom as a company has been on this journey for a long time, creating multiplayer worlds where players can live out their dreams and fantasies. We were there in the beginning with massively multiplayer online games. We've been there in the beginning with survival open world crafting games. And Dune is a combination of those legacies, bringing us forward into the future. It's the culmination of what Funcom means as a company and what we can deliver. And this legacy means that we need to really pay attention to what we're creating and how we create it for the fans. Because I think at the heart of this, there's a lot of people out there who really want to live in the universe that Frank Herbert created. And they really want to live in the visual world of the films that they see from Villeneuve. And so we need to create the gap between those two possibility spaces and create a game world where people can live out their fantasies that they've taken from Dune.
Is there any Kazakh people in Poland? I don't know, bro.
It feels at times extremely overwhelming. But we really hope that we can deliver something for everybody.
No, I haven't met any Kazakhstan people. To be honest. The Thaumaturge. I mamy oficjalny trailer.
Look at yourself. What happened?
You say you're a wizard from an imaginary country that no one has seen on
imaginary country. Kocham to.
I haven't had my first coffee yet.
Urojony, wymyślony.
What kind of a man are you?
Right, that's what thaumaturges do. Professionally touch things.
Touchy-touchy.
Russian scum. What did you say?
After all, that's how Father built this store.
Whose soul are you summoning tonight, dear madame?
I only know which one I'd prefer to banish. Shoot.
What the fuck? Who brought a demon into my yacht?
Although, hang on now. A demon is a good publicity.
Was that jealousy I hear?
Stand here, right now! Bullets fly every which way here. Was someone killed? Probably. But that's not very unusual.
Come on. Those two brain cells you still have will appreciate a break from rules and trouble.
Just don't embarrass us thaumaturges.
As a thaumaturge, you should know best of all that anything worth the effort has its price.
Oh my.
Now our journey is really beginning. Just remember, there's no turning back.
Oczywiście, Rasputin, rozumiemy. Gdyby to hell. Yeah. Yeah. Sinduality. Echo of Ada. Było z mechami, nie? Jakimiś takimi... Nie wiem, jeszcze jakimiś... Nie wiem, ala duchem? Ale głównie mechy. How many trailers there? A lot. I usually watch 1 hour of trailers. In total. So around 30, maybe 40 trailers, depends. How long they are. Three computer games one? Yeah. To be honest, I'm up to date, to be honest. Those are the fresh ones. Those are not the old ones, so yeah. Enjoy, yeah. Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3, sezon drugi, Reloaded Zombies.
More zombies.
Uzbekistan tam był? Dobrze widziałem? Yeah, I think I saw the Uzbekistan sign. Co to jest? A Mortal Kombat 1. You Hollywood types are all soft and weak. Don't invade. Uzbekistan.
I'm John Cena, and I get the honor of playing Peacemaker in Mortal Kombat 1.
It's John Cena.
Trash talker. Dickweed. He's brash. Man, it's a whole lot of attitude.
Suck on that.
To be
be in the Mortal Kombat 1 universe and now be up against competitors like Scorpion and Sub-Zero, I mean, I'm hitting with Hall of Famers.
Jesus! What the hell?
The Mortal Kombat 1 roster is so stacked, but I just gotta be selfish here. My favorite character is Peacemaker.
Czy lubi swoją postać? Dubiemy oczka. Booze, yeah.
Activate Sonic Boom.
Fatality. Flawless victory.
Peace unlocked.
Yeah, American Peacemaker uses guns and fists. Dragon is dead. Cóż to? Oh. Spoko to wygląda nawet. Siada taka Castlevania. Played only 74 games through your life? Well, bro. You should play more games. To be honest, I didn't know how many games I played through my life, but a lot. Chivalry 2. From Chivalry. Tak zwał. Yeah, you are more filthy casual than me. For myself, I'm calling myself a filthy casual, to be honest. Pospolite ruszenie na pochybę. Serio? Z kurczakiem? Duel of the Pities. Okej. Okay. No i tu kurde dają darmowe coiny. A w Diablo nie dają nawet. Świnie. The Outlast Trials 1.0. Yeah, Polish Brawl.
In the Arizona desert, the Murkoff Corporation is perpetrating unspeakable crimes. You have been chosen, one of the lucky few plucked from the gutters by Dr. Hendrik Joliet Easterman to be conditioned in
the trial.
You are a reagent, a trial subject stripped of all identity, forced into twisted experiments. Alone or in teams of up to four, You will try to earn your rebirth as Murkoff's perfect sleeper agent. The trials are designed to be a brutal assault on the self inhabited by the experimental population. Former test subjects driven to a state of constant homicidal rage by
Czeko the jesteś?
Murkoff builds each trial around a narrative, a twisted reflection of the world outside. Reagents are assigned a series of objectives designed to test their survival and break their sanity. Stay quiet. Stay in the shadows. Use your night vision goggles. Hide if you can. Run if you have to. If the X-Pop spots you, improvise. You can buy yourself a little time with a bottle or a brick. And at the center of each trial, the prime assets. Charismatic murderers transformed by Murkoff's therapy into monsters. Mother Gooseberry, a disgraced children's television host driven by misguided family values.
It's grinding time.
Dr. Futterman, a tooth goose puppet concealing an electric drill. Sergeant Leland Coyle, a psychosexual sadist, obsessed and aroused by punishment and authority. The trials will force you into painful and contradictory tasks, stripping your psyche bare so that it can be rebuilt in the sleep room. A place for healing and socialization. In the sleep room, you can customize your character and cell, expressing your identity on your path to rebirth, and unwind in games of strength and strategy. Some of the Murkoff employees in the sleep room are just as captive as the reagents. Each offers useful upgrades and has their own story, revealing deeper horrors in Murkoff's agenda. You'll customize your loadout, alone or in cooperation with other reagents, taking an active hand in shaping your own therapy. As Dr. Easterman likes to say, we're all getting better together. Your therapy is a journey, and it's up to you if it ends. Completing core therapy opens a path to rebirth, where one final trial earns your release. But the trials are designed to grow. Program X, Program Ultra, and weekly challenges all offer unique rewards designed to traumatize those to their journey for perfection. Nothing can stop the march of science and history. The trials will evolve and expand, revealing new challenges, characters, and stories. Untold thousands have found their home in the trials. Now it's your turn to enjoy Murkoff's hospitality.
And be reborn.
Let the trials begin.
Stabby stab. Tak, ale Outlast taki właśnie jest. Mocno krwisty. Okej. Life Eater. Lord of the Earth.
And that name is Zimforth. The things I must do to serve him are cruel and vicious. But if I don't do this year after
you don't
year,
like playing horrors, the world you're very end. Afraid of them. I'm loving the horror games and movies.
I am my God's precious sinner, abducting beasts for the slaughter that saves the world. And this year, Zimforth has given me just 3 days to do it.
I might like body horror movies. What do you mean by body horror movies?
kasy.
Halo Infinite. I to wszystko za walutę. Realnie. New Chimeras. Fajne kolorowe. Ale po co to komu i na co to komu? Shop item, co ja mówiłem? Skiny dodali. Mi tylko transakcje. Flag restored. Project Tower.
To all the survivors, this is not a drill. This is your last chance to hear a voice from the world that was. If you're hearing this, it means the invaders have already reached our doorstep. Humanity's time is running out. It's been a few days since they first descended upon us. An extraterrestrial force hell-bent on wiping us out.
Shooter, third person.
Cities have crumbled. Families torn apart. We are witnessing the end of an era. Stop broadcasting until the last breath leaves my body. The world as we knew it is gone. But
we can't forget who we are. Fighters, dreamers, and survivors.
Survivors. Thank you. Sons of Valhalla!
And I am looking for my wife, Rhea. Their trail led me to you.
Niewolnice. Pięknie.
Follow me.
Yeah, yeah. Pixel art games are pretty cool. Not all of them, but yeah. But this one is pretty, pretty cool, to be honest, yeah.
It is your destiny to save her. I will support you in this.
My son? Let me get them. Kill them all. May the Valhalla be with you. Pięknie. Zasoby, ludzie. Spoko, bo to taki trochę... Ale taki tower defense, ale inny. Nie jest taki standardowy. Dragon's Dogma 2, Trickster. Kurde, Dragon's Dogma też soon. Niestety, kurde, soon. Sakra. Z tymi gierkami. Reveal. To jest horrorek. Procentowo. Nawet polski. Powiedział.
Hello? Can somebody hear me? I've been trying to reach someone.
Nie, to chyba nie jest polski. Przepraszam bardzo.
I'm stuck in some crazy dream, nightmare cycle.
I don't even know how to say it.
I feel like I'm... Like I'm losing my mind.
My daughter. My wife.
I understand. It's improbable to have the upper hand.
Klauny, cyrk. Who am I?
There's a monster in the...
And they're dead!
Maybe it's pointless, but... I'll keep leaving those messages. My name is Walter Thompson. Please help me.
I'm just a painter. Reality is falling apart. Pięknie, pięknie.
Hi.
House Flipper 2.
So, tell me how you're doing. Everything's fine and dandy. I gotta tell you, I'm still a bit tired after the concert. We had such a blast. But you can probably tell that by the look of the house.
Hey, Jaden here. I finally know what my movie's gonna be about, and I couldn't wait to tell you. It's It's going to be a silent piece, honoring the simple life. Imagine long, static shots capturing the most mundane activities.
I've had a microwave which disappeared mysteriously some time ago. Jack, my roommate, says he has no idea what happened to it, but I have my suspicions. So, if you find it in his room, could you move it to the kitchen? Though, I wouldn't be surprised if he sold it or something. Good luck with the
job. Wysoko, kurde, nawet IGN trochę słabiej oceny widzę. 7 na 10, ale tak to wysokie oceny ma. House Flipper. To jest dla tych osób, które, kurde, chyba mocno lubią ją upiększać chatki. Albo generalnie dekorować. Czy tam remontować nawet, bym powiedział. Spoko. Persona 3 Reload.
もうすぐ終わりが来る。あの日、君はいろいろと不思議な体験をしたはずだ。うすうすは感じたんじゃないか。自分が普通と違う時間をくぐったこと。君の力を貸してほしい。あなたを倒す。俺らの学校どこ行っちまったんだよ。私の生きる証。運命は生かした。ふざけるな。私は選ばれた。もう決めたぜ。
Też kiedyś musimy, kurde, usiąść do Persony. Naprawdę, kurde, no, to są gigantyczne ilości godzin. Jedyny plus, że ten trailer jest po japońsku.
Nice.
Pięknie. Ghost of Tsushima, Director's Cut, PC Official. Pięknie. They're like anime, yeah. I'm weep. Be honest.
I will kill them all.
Na Ghost of Tsushima się czekamy. Idziska. Kiedy wychodzi? W maju? 16 maja chyba wychodzi Ghost of Tsushima? Weep. Not whip. Weep. W-E... No, not E. A-A-B. Weep. So out.
I sacrificed everything for my people.
Czekaj, co-opik jakiś? Really? Tak, 16 maja. Coming to PC. Pięknie, pięknie. DNF Duel Monk gameplay. Teraz chyba 8 minut, więc trochę sobie przeskoczymy. Battle Mage. JJ. Tylko The Outlast Trials wyszły już w finalnej wersji. Gramy w kopa?
Nie
Ile cebulinów? Nie mam bladego pojęcia, powiem ci szczerze. Na Steamie kosztuje 185. Na Steamie kosztuje 185, a na Instant Gaming... To na Instant Gaming kosztuje 114. Fajto! Coś to na się better, no? No, zdecydowanie better. Niż 185, nie? Praktycznie 7 dych w kieszeni. Chyba specjalnie, kurde, dali Battle Mage'a, kurde, nie? Typowy fanservice. Dobra, wskoczmy sobie trochę ten. Round 3, fight! Combo. Ale ten gracz jest cienki, kurde. Tak się daje sponiewierać. Yeah, this is a trailer. Of a gameplay. Yeah. DNF Duel. Pokazują mnicha jako postać. New Challenger. Weźmy się tutaj, kawałek dalej. O, on jest trochę długi, on tam ile? 8 minut? Tylko sobie skipujemy. I średni? Znaczy no... Ziemuś, który gra z tym mnichem, jest generalnie średni. Daje się tak mocno sponiewierać, że szkoda gadać. Resident Sleeper. Tak trochę, no. Tak trochę. Chodzimy do KO. Crown Wars, The Black Prince.
I'm the lord of your domain. It's the last bastion against the evil plans of the order.
The evil plans.
You can recruit and train our soldiers for future battles. To equip them with the best weapons and armor, you need to go to the forge. If some of our soldiers sustain wounds despite this preparation, they can be treated in the chapel. We can also capture enemy prisoners to increase our battle spirit.
Czekaj, co on mu tam zrobił? Go kleptą tylko po plecach? Już się poddaje?
Is where we design and create new tools, such as blazing arrows, grenades, or powerful bombs for our future battles. Use the market to trade resources and balance your economy according to your needs. And finally, from the Lord Hall, your seat of operations, strategically deploy your troops. With the world on the brink of collapse, there can only be one solution. The order must be defeated.
The weird dream. O, króliczek. Ten zajączek, whatever. Taką gierkę dla ciebie. Przemarzyłą kokardkę jakąś. Nie? Czekaj, więc czy te elementy takie tego biało-czarnego są specjalne? Czy tego dodali do trailera? Everybody turns useless? Some.
Just so happens they frame the wrong witch.
Wiedźma?
They call me Lady Luck.
Lady Luck.
Every card I draw is lucky. And when I find out what my old coven is up to, they better hope they have a good hand. Not tonight, boys.
Wiedźmin? No, that's not the Witcher.
If the coven wants
it's the
to
witch.
Play, they'll have to play dirty.
Okay. The Altars. I na to czekamy. Na to też czekamy, ludziska. To może być śmieszna gierka. Bekowa strasznie. Polska jest w ogóle The Altars.
What if
The Altars jest Polska.
The decisions you regret in your life. And see the outcomes of those choices.
Od 11 Beats Studios.
The Altars tells the story of Yandolz, a simple miner who survived a crash landing on a hostile planet. He quickly realizes that what was supposed to be a lifetime job opportunity turns into a desperate fight for his life. Yan will need to handle a large mobile base that's designed to be operated by an entire team of qualified personnel. Even worse, the planet Yan landed on revolves around the deadly scorching star. Escaping the sunrise is crucial for survival. Despite his best efforts, Yan simply lacks the time and skills to deal with all these problems on his own.
But the planet Yan is stranded on is home to a mysterious substance called Rapidium. With its use and the help of the quantum computer on board,
Yan is able to
create alternative versions of himself. De-alters. Each one of them is the result of altering a crucial decision from Yan's past. The alters are a reflection of the questions he asks himself. What if I never left my hometown? What if I didn't drop out of college? What if I fought harder to save my marriage? Our alters have the necessary knowledge and skills that we desperately need to succeed. But they also come with their own goals, ambitions, and fears, all derived from their different life paths. And that can generate problems.
Stop pretending you have any idea how I feel.
Incompetence. Incoherent decision-making. A groundbreaking mission on the verge of failure.
Damn. I just hope I don't f*** everything up again.
You want a relationship that lasts. Put some effort in it.
Each Yan is a different person. It will be extremely difficult to keep everyone happy.
You gotta learn how to say no sometimes.
But we must do whatever we can, because as the mission goes on, the challenges will only pile up. Obstacles on the
internal tensions
that could prove to be even more dangerous. And with a ticking clock of the deathly sun behind our backs, the only way home is to press forward.
Pięknie. Mocno jestem ciekawy. The Alters. Tylko dali różowe tło. Coś dla siebie. Sugeruję, żebyś grała w The Alters. Frostpunk 2.
Jest.
Nie masz czasu. Przewózek zawczasu. No na Frostpunka też czekamy. Ale zobaczmy. Kiedy release? Damn. Po prostu cała kolonia, całe miasto bym wręcz powiedział, nie? July. W lipcu, 25 lipca. Damn. Nice. Nice, nice, nice. I tak, ludziska, dobrnęliśmy do końca dzisiejszego odcinka, także dzięki wielkie za oglądanie i widzimy się już niedługo. Kolejny. Trzymajcie się. Hej, hej.